Hello, everyone, and welcome to this Coliseum exclusive here in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canada. Gorilla Monsoon along with his lordship, Alfred Hayes.
Easy for you to say, the Saska Zola.
You know, Alfred, that this is the hometown of the father of that man right there, Bret the Hitman Hart, Stu Hart.
I didn't know that. I thought he was born and bred in Calgary.
Absolutely not. Saskatoon is where he was born and bred. And what a golden opportunity for Bret the Hitman Hart.
Well, good for him, and I'm sure there's many, many of his family who still live here in Saskatoon who are in attendance here. In fact, there must be lots and lots of them because I can hear a lot of cheering.
Boy, there's hearts all over the place, Albert.
Have a heart.
Just in his family alone, I believe there was 13.
Children?
Children.
Oh, gosh. How many sons, how many daughters? Any idea?
I think there were 7 boys and 6 girls.
Six, seven. That's 13. You're right. That's very good.
Uh-oh, here he comes.
Accompanied down the aisle by his
reigning champion,
Mr. Perfect,
Ric Flair.
From Charlotte, North Carolina.
Gorilla, what a combination these two have turned out to be. The flawless one, Mr. Perfect, the guiding light there behind Ric Flair, the champion. And he certainly has shown him the way to scale that ladder right to the very zenith of the World Wrestling Federation. And I must say that this man is not only colorful, but he is great in everything he does. Ric Flair, a true champion's champion.
Boy, he's not above getting involved either, Alfred. Mr. Perfect, should things start to get a little bit out of hand.
Well, he keeps the situation well in hand. You're absolutely right. If he does become involved, well, it's necessary. And why not?
Bret the Hitman Hart knows what it's like to have that gold around your waist. Former Intercontinental Champion on several occasions, I might add.
Yes.
And look at this capacity crowd. They are in for a treat.
They really are. They really are. And as I look in the ring there at Bret Hart, a little bit later on, we're going to see him when he's in combat executing some of those moves that he does so wonderfully well. And I always love to use your quotation, the excellence of execution that this man has achieved. You coined such a wonderful quote there.
Well, he certainly does that, Alfred. Got all the tools necessary. Spent a lifetime, devoted his entire life to this, to this moment right here.
Yes. You know, another thing I like about Bret Hart is he is so confident, but he's not overconfident. He doesn't smile. He doesn't sneer or snort. He's quite expressionless in many, many things. But my word, is he businesslike.
And always thinking. 2 or 3 moves ahead constantly as well. Ric Flair resembles that remark in the same fashion. Tremendous champion. Taking on all comers.
The only difference between these two is not necessarily in skill, size, weight, or ability, but the fact that Flair does sometimes tend to showboat just a fraction too much. Sometimes it's a show of confidence. Sometimes it rattles his opponents, but he's not going to rattle Bret Hart in any way whatsoever.
Sometimes his ego, your lordship, just forces him to do that. Makes him do that.
Well, it happens to all of us.
I don't blame him.
No. When I was wrestling, I certainly had an ego. I know that.
Nice hammerlock here by the Hitman, who's talking to the champ, too.
Taunting is a better word, I think. Maybe mocking him a little, do you think?
Well, maybe.
I've never seen Bret Hart do that before, have you?
Might be another nice change of pace for Bret.
Maybe, you're absolutely right. I tell you something, he certainly stepped into the ring here today full of confidence, Mr. Perfect.
He doesn't have a chance.
He doesn't have a chance, huh? We'll see. If anybody has a chance, the Hitman does.
Well, Mr. Perfect, a very wise person, very well scored in the art of how to beat an opponent. Neither him nor Flair ever come to the ring expecting anything else but victory. I like that attitude. They come for a win.
You know, Alfred, when Perfect was the Intercontinental Champion. It was said by people in the know that he was the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time.
I would have to endorse that remark, yes. What a tremendous battle that would be between Bret Hart and Mr. Perfect, for example.
Oh, boy.
The match
Or Mr. Perfect and Ric Flair, for that matter.
Well, yes, I'd like to see that, too.
I'd buy a ticket for that.
I think I definitely would buy a ticket. I'd buy several tickets for that. I treat my friends, and I don't often do that.
Yes, I've heard that, Alfred.
Incidentally, is that true that Heenan and his colleague, Mean Gene Oakland, are always running tabs up on you?
Yes, they are, both of them.
They go out to dinner.
Talking about leeches, what a couple of leeches those guys are.
And that fellow, Mean Gene Oakland, always being so nice to you.
Always to your face, Alfred.
Yes.
But behind your back, it's the big knife right in.
I'm sure of that.
Oh, look at this, a cover. Sort of surprised him more than anything else. You've got to have Flair in a lot more of a compromising position than that.
Yes, he will really suck you in at times, Flair. You'll think he's hurt very, very badly indeed, and he'll bring you right into a trap. He can bait a trap better than anybody else I've seen in the World Wrestling Federation.
A little bit early for the sharpshooter. We may see it, though. He just planted one right in the abdomen instead.
Isn't that superb, Wrestling Gorilla? Look at that. Self-discipline being shown there by Bret Hart. He's not going to rush into anything foolish. He doesn't step where angels fear to tread. He just waits his time. He is so good with everything he does.
And Ric Flair, the champion, wisely buying himself a little time here.
Yes, Alp Coliseum cameraman here, giving you some excellent shots. They are so intrepid, they take you right into the action, and if somebody's on the outside, what is the number of that cameraman there?
I believe it's 5, Alfred.
Number 5 cameraman, he's always getting some really good stuff on the outside.
Especially when he gets his wake-up call. Then he's really on it.
What about breakfast? Is he on the
Oh, yeah, he's all right for breakfast. Look at this. We've been out here now around 7, 8, maybe close to 10. 10 minutes going. Hitman is yet to break a sweat.
I think you're absolutely right, but for that matter, so is Flair. These men in superb physical condition. Mr. Perfect makes sure that every time Flair steps into the ring, he is in 100% physical condition.
Standing wrist lock by the champion. Challenger with a nice counter of a wrist lock of his own. Took him over with it. Had the leverage. Flair didn't like that.
No, he didn't. And one thing Bret Hart is showing us here, he's got a little increased power in his armory now. He's obviously strengthened that side of his weaponry up. And he's persistent with his hold. He's not breaking now. I really like that. Just bent that rule right to the very edge.
Well, he had a 5 count there to get out. Right on top of everything, as always. Strictly business. The Hitman is all business.
Great moves. I just sit here in absolute astonishment at some of the stuff he does. That was a nice short takedown just by the arm alone. Brought him right across the top.
And maintains control with this nice armbar. And Flair obviously in a lot of pain here.
He certainly is, and this is most unusual. The champion not wilting, but certainly hurting.
But you know, Alfred, Flair has so many things in his arsenal. So many things he can put you away with. And you can bet the Hitman knows that.
No, definitely. And look at this. Here's the hallmark of a great wrestler coming back to that left arm of Flair. Once you get a limb injured, look at that.
Oh, right back on it.
Oh, gosh.
Nice series of moves. Hitman ends up with a hammerlock and right back on that left arm again.
And that, I hate to belabor a saying, but that is absolutely superb execution.
Concerned look on the face moments ago of Mr. Perfect.
Well, the controller stayed with Bret Hart now for about the last 5 or so minutes. In the beginning, there were some flashy moves from him that didn't amount to much, and Flair weathered those quite easily, but I don't think he's weathering this one. He's trying to figure something out in his mind how to get away from this persistent holding of his left arm by Bret Hart. Champion's in trouble, Gorilla.
Well, a little bit so, I think, Alfred. I think there was a previous injury to that left elbow area, and the Hitman obviously was aware of that and is taking advantage of it, and I don't blame him. Find a spot, go to work on it.
Our third man doing a good job there, very close to the action, right in on everything. So far, he hasn't had to interfere too much. He's not a very tolerant man, this referee.
Right back to that arm wringer and control again. Well, you either go over like that, Alfred, or you break your arm.
Yes.
It's as simple as that.
Absolutely, and that type of breakage, right in the shoulder socket, you're never going to make a recovery from.
See, now that was a mistake that the Hitman should never make. Walked right in there, wide open, thinking he had the champion in a compromising position, but he really didn't.
Well, I suspect you can do that to 99 wrestlers, but Ric Flair is 1 in 100, probably 1 in 1,000,000. You just don't get away with it with him.
Now he's going to buy himself a little bit more time here by eliminating the Hitman over the top rope, down to the concrete. Oh, nice shoulder block. Slingshot over the top.
And I was about to say that was good strategy by Flair, but it backfired up to that point. Good backing up move there, kept his balance, did it beautifully.